While Eli is seeing some birds return to the Koa forest, some other birds are being pushed to the edge of extinction. Fortunately, there's a group just down the hill from Eli's project trying to reverse that trend.
On the slopes of Mauna Loa, there exists a sanctuary like no other in the world. This is the place where Hawaii's rarest birds are born, in an effort to replenish the once thriving avian community.
Hawaii has some of the most endangered birds in the world for many reasons. Some of the birds are endemic to just the Hawaiian islands. Some of them are endemic to certain islands in Hawaii and even certain habitat in Hawaii. So this kind of limited distribution and the only fact they're only found here in Hawaii makes them really vulnerable.
Robby Kohley is a research coordinator here at the Keauhou Bird Conservation Center. He's involved with the Hawaii Endangered Bird Conservation Program, a unique partnership between the San Diego Zoo, the state of Hawaii, the U.S. government, and the landowner, Kamehameha Schools. They've all joined forces here on the Big Island to nurture some of the world's most threatened forest birds. With 8 full-time staff and a handful of interns, the Keauhou Bird Conservation Center focuses its efforts in raising endangered birds. With 12 breeding aviaries, meal preparation is an important part of the day. There are at least 100 birds on the property, and at times twice that many, so just day-to-day maintenance is a full-time task.
This location is incredible. It's one of a kind. The resources and what we're able to do on this land is really helpful. It gives us a place to work that's out of the way, so the birds are just not disturbed. We have access to build more aviaries, and then we have native habitat for berries for lots of reasons to enrich the birds and to help this program work.
A captive breeding program is used as a way to propagate rare birds such as these pu'ai ohi, or small Kauai thrush. Endemic only to the Alaka'i swamp on Kauai, there are just a few hundred left in the wild. Robby's team hand feeds these birds as often as once an hour until they're mature. The adults are then relocated to their remote habitat on the Garden Island, where they'll have a chance to breed in the wild and repopulate. The Hawaiian crow is one of those birds now extinct in the wild, and the current population count is around 50. So one of the only places in the world you can find one of these elusive creatures is here in Keauhou. In the state-of-the-art Alala breeding facility, each group of birds is monitored 24 hours a day. Charts are kept on just about every behavior. All this information goes toward increasing success rates and generating more healthy chicks in the future.
It's important to bring back these bird populations because it's important to remember these birds are found only here in the Hawaiian Islands. So they're a special part of Hawaiian culture and just unique to Hawaii. And anything that we can do as far as habitat protection and captive prob to do to protect these birds is important to everybody.
In time, these birds could be removed from the endangered list. So one day our children, or our children's children, will be able to enjoy them again.
While Eli and the people at the Keauhou Bird Conservation Center are working to bring back balance to the Mauka areas of the Big Island, there are other groups working with Kamehameha Schools to restore other parts of the Ahupua'a. When we return, we'll visit these projects and meet the people using those lessons from Hawaii's past to guide them into a more sustainable future.